In this lesson, we will look at four examples of using proportions in order to solve application problems. For A, the ratio of the lengths of corresponding sides of two similar decagons is 1:2. If the perimeter of the smaller decagon is 76 centimeters, what is the perimeter of the larger decagon? A decagon is a polygon with 10 sides. To determine the perimeter of a polygon, we add the lengths of the sides. And therefore, because the ratio of the lengths of the corresponding sides is 1:2, then the ratio of their perimeters is also 1:2. To answer the question, we'll set up a proportion. A proportion is formed when we set two rates or ratios equal to each other. So the ratio of 1:2, or 1 centimeter to 2 centimeters, must equal the ratio of their perimeters. And this ratio is comparing the length of the smaller decagon to the length of the larger decagon, and therefore this ratio would have to be 76 centimeters, the perimeter of the smaller decagon, to the unknown perimeter of the larger decagon, which would be an unknown number of centimeters. We create equivalent ratios or rates, just like we create equivalent fractions. So because 1 centimeter times 76 equals 76 centimeters, 2 centimeters times 76 will give us the perimeter of the larger decagon. Well, 2 times 76 equals 152, and therefore the perimeter of the larger decagon is 152 centimeters. For part B, a cookie recipe requires 4 cups of flour to make 5 dozen cookies. If Amy needs to make 15 dozen cookies, how many cups of flour will she need? Let's begin with the rate comparing the cups of flour to the number of cookies. The rate is 4 cups of flour per 5 dozen cookies. We need an equivalent rate that compares the number of cups of flour to 15 dozen cookies. And because 5 times 3 is equal to 15, 4 times 3 will give us number of cups of flour per 15 dozen cookies. Well, 4 times 3 equals 12, and therefore it takes 12 cups of flour to make 15 dozen cookies. For part C, the president of the student body estimated that 2 out of every 3 students at school would attend the spring festival. If there are 1,140 students at this school, according to this estimate, how many students will not attend the spring festival? Well, the ratio of 2:3 gives us the ratio of students attending to the total students, and therefore the ratio of 1:3 gives us the ratio of students not attending to the total number of students. So we need to be careful about the wording here, because the estimate is about how many students will not attend. So the ratio of 1 student to 3 students is the ratio of the students not attending to the total number of students. And therefore, to determine how many students will not attend out of 1,140, we want an equivalent ratio comparing the unknown number of students that won't attend to the total number of students, which is 1,140 students. Looking at the quotient on the right, this tells us that 3 times 380 is equal to 1,140, and therefore to find the ratio we're looking for, we multiply 3 by 380 as well as 1. 1 times 380 is 380, which tells us the estimate is 380 students will not attend the spring festival. For D, if one bus holds 60 students, how many buses are needed to take 780 students to the Valley Fair? So the given rate is 1 bus per 60 students. We need an equivalent rate, the number of buses, which is unknown, per 780 students. To determine the equivalent rate, we need to determine what times 60 is equal to 780. Looking at the quotient on the right, we can see 60 times 13 equals 780. And therefore, to create the equivalent rate, we multiply 60 students by 13 as well as one bus. Well, one bus times 13 equals 13. So the equivalent rate is 13 buses per 780 students. And now we know 13 buses are needed to take 780 students to the Valley Fair. I hope you found this helpful.